Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to quickly add page numbers to your InDesign document. And these will automatically update, so if you rearrange the pages, they'll still be numbered correctly, if that makes sense. Now I'm going to show you two ways. One with facing pages, if your document is set up that way, and then one without facing pages, so just single pages. And I actually have a more detailed version of this video, and that will be right up here on your screen above. So you can check that out if you kind of want to know the really deep dive into it. All right, let's get started. Okay, so first I'll show you with facing pages. Now the way I set this document up, I went to File, New, or Command N or Control N, and I checked facing pages right here. So if you're going with a letter size, you would just put 8.5 by 11 and then choose facing pages to get something like this. So first we'll need to open our pages window. To do that, you can go to Window, Pages right here. And then you'll see the A master at the top. Now when you set this up, normally you'll just have your A master and then all the pages that are in there will already have A set up for them. But if they don't, I'll show you how to do that really quickly. Okay, so we double click our A master and that'll bring us to this page. I'm going to hit T on my keyboard, which will bring me to the text tool right over here. And I'm going to have my first page number be right here. So I've zoomed in and now I'm going to draw my text box. And this is where our page number will go. So to get the page number in there, I'm going to go up to Type, Insert Special Character, Markers, and Current Page Number. And it'll add an A right here. Now that seems strange, doesn't it? But that's what we want. It's okay that it says A. Now I'm going to go to Window, Type in Tables, and Paragraph. And this will open our paragraph window and we can write justify right here. If this becomes 300 pages, it'll start from this point instead of starting to go off the page, if that makes sense. And I'm going to get my selection tool, select this, and just move it to the place I like the best, which is right about here. I can also change my font and that kind of thing here. This is in my character panel, which is also in Window, Type in Tables, and Character. So we have our right side number set up. Now I'm going to come over here and draw another text box on the left side. And I'm going to do the same thing. So we'll go to Type, Insert Special Character, Markers, and Current Page Number. And this will also put another A. Now this one I want to be left justified. I'm going to move it down to be about on the same plane as our other page number right over here. And this is all within the master. So you had double clicked up here and you're in your master right now. Now we need to get out of the master. So to do that, you can just come down to any page number and double click it. And now you can see that you have your page number set up. And even if you go down here to number 15, you can see page 14 and 15 are here. So it automatically numbers all the pages that use A master. And you can see the little A's on all of these. Now, if you had a second master page and you wanted some of these to pull from that master page, you can just select them like this, holding shift and selecting however many you want. Then right click and choose Apply Master to Pages. Then you can choose which master page to apply to those three pages that you selected. And then just say okay. Okay, so that is the way to do it with facing pages. Now with no facing pages, it's the exact same method. When you create your document, you'll have the option to choose no facing pages. So the pages won't be connected to the one beside it, if that makes sense. They'll look like this. So if we go to File, New, we can just uncheck facing pages and we'll get a result like this. Okay, now the process is the same here. Since these are not facing pages, I'm going to assume that maybe they're stapled up in the corner or something like that. So I want the page number to be right in the middle. Another option would be to put it over here, but I'll do a middle one for these. So I'm going to double click this. Now I'm in the master. It looks the same, but the difference is you're double clicked here, which would only change the settings on this page. If you click in the master, you're going to be changing the settings on all of these pages that have the little A on them. Okay, so I'm going to hit T to get on my text tool, which is right over here. I'm going to draw a little text box. Then I'm going to go to Type, Insert Special Character, Markers, and Current Page Number. Now this one, since it's right in the middle, I want it to be center justified. So I'm going to select all with Command A, and then I'm going to hit Shift, Command, and C to center. That's Shift, Control, C on a PC. And then I'll get back on my selection tool, and this time I'm going to bring up my alignment tools. So I sometimes have to go to help and just search for align right here. But those are in object and layout and then align. So I'll click that. I'm going to change align to, I'm going to put it to the page. So now whatever I align will be based on the page itself. So I'll choose the center one. And now it is perfectly centered right in the middle. And we can get rid of that. I'm going to move this down with my arrow keys a little bit. And now I'm still in this master page, but I can double click on page one. And you can see that our page has updated with the number one, and it's updated on all of them. Now, if you want the page numbers to start on any page you want, maybe you don't want them to start on page one, there's another video I made that shows specifically how to do that, and that'll be in the description below. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and a little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.